shackles, no more chains, no more bondage. I am free. Yeah.
Come on, give God some praise. I want to challenge you. The beat's still going. We're still going. I want to challenge you to get out of your seat. Go find your neighbor, a partner, somebody, and tell them how good God has been to you. And tell them you got freedom in God's house today. Come on, get up and move and go tell them. Yeah, that's right. It's all right to move in God's house. Come on, we got freedom. Freedom, let me hear it. Those hands and make some noise in the house of God. How many folks got freedom?
Glory.
For real freedom.
Glory.
If you know you're free, lift those hands up. You don't care what nobody says about you, thinks about you.
Hallelujah.
They weren't there when God saved you. They weren't there when God healed you. They weren't there when God delivered you, so what do you care about what they think about you giving God praise this morning? Lift those hands up. How many love Jesus?
Come on, everybody, let's just begin to lift up the name of Jesus in this house on today. Let's begin to lift up the name of Jesus. Let's begin to magnify his name. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Something happens when I call you. When I call you, come on, praise team, begin to sing Jesus with me. Say Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
If you know the song, begin to sing along with
Jesus,
us.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Something happened.
Something happened when I call you.
Oh Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Oh Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Something happened.
Something happened.
And when I call you,
when I call you.
Oh Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Something happened.
And when I
call you, when I
call you. Happens when we call on the name.
Something happens.
Say when I
call,
take us up higher. Say Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Oh Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Something happens when we call on the name.
Something happens
when I call you.
When I call you.
Hey,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Something happens, yeah.
Happens.
When I call
when
you,
I call
oh
you.
Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Oh Jesus, Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Something happens when we call on the name.
Something happens when I call.
Mention of your name, every knee will bow and tongue proclaim, Jesus, Jesus. You are Savior, you are Lord, and you are God. Come on, if you know the name, begin to call on the name of Jesus. Savior, you are Lord, and you are God. the mention of your name, every knee will bow and tongue proclaim. Savior, you are Lord, and you are God.
I feel the weight of glory in this place this morning. I feel the weight of glory in this place this morning. And I feel like somebody brought me a present wrapped up in a bow. A purple package with a yellow bow on top of it. And it's a big box of something inside of it. And it's all given to me, given to you. It's like a package specifically made with your name on it. And that package is Jesus Christ this morning, I'm telling you. A package of favor, a package of prosperity and deliverance, all in the package. Hallelujah. I don't know how far we're going to go in the service, but if I were you, I'd lift my hands in this place. Not because I told you to, because what he's done up until this point in your life. He is worthy. Yes, he is. Oh! God, we reverence you how? With our hands raised, our hearts ready to receive, our minds been regulated to give you the praise this morning. So God, we give you praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Sweet Savior. Hallelujah. Don't you feel like worshiping him in this room? It's a worshiping anointing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Come on, y'all, praise sing. Hallelujah. It's wearing over this place to fulfill every need. Hallelujah. There's a sweet aroma. It's moving in this place. Hallelujah. Come on, you know what's singing. You know what's singing.
Belongs to you.
Come on.
My hallelujah belongs to you. My hallelujah belongs to you.
Come on, you know what? Say it. Say it. Right there, if you will. Give him some praise. Come on, you can do better than that. Hallelujah. Oh! Hold on a minute. Wait a minute. Hold on 1 second, young people. And what you with me last night watching the fight, some of y'all was cheering on, what's his name? Mayweather. He won. Everybody, yeah. Another guy lost. Folk were crying. We can do better than that. Come on, one more time. Give God some praise. As you get older, boy, you appreciate the air you breathe. You appreciate when your legs hurt and you get up out the bed. You appreciate your back with hurt because you work so hard walking. You appreciate everything in your refrigerator. You appreciate as you get older. Woo! My God. That's where I've been. I appreciate my mother. I appreciate as I get older. God, I thank you. Some of y'all remember pork and beans. That's all you had, but glory, you got pork and beans, filet, pork and beans, and all kind of, they just mix pork and beans with everything. They think it's something new now. This ain't nothing new. Let's go back in the early 50s and when they couldn't afford enough pork and beans and hot dogs. And my mama made a casserole out of pork. How'd she do that? That's why we're here this morning, because we're giving him praise. We appreciate the moment I walk out this house and I didn't get hit by a car. If I were you, I'd lift my hands, stand on my feet, give God a glory. Shout, thank you, Lord. I got a place to live. I got a place to eat. I got a place to sleep. I got to. My God, I made the free preaching here this morning. Y'all love him too much, huh? Do you love him? Say something. Do you love him? Do you love him? Hallelujah. Come on, praise team. You may be seated. Come on, sweetheart. You're pretty self. Come on up here.
I love him. I love him. And I love you too.
Amen.
Glory to God. Let's give God a hand of praise for who he is today. He deserves. Hallelujah. Oh, look who's sitting back there, my Sue. You know, as I was sitting there, when you're amongst people that believe God, you're going through pure hell. Girl, you going through some stuff, and you in the right place today to hear the right word that take you up out of where you are. Hallelujah. I just believe today is a day of miracles. I believe today is a day that God wants to do something for you. I think he wants to help your mind shift to another dimension today.
Glory.
Look at your neighbor and say, I am on fire, because this church is on fire. I'm going to go there. I don't want to sit next to somebody that's always grooming, doing it, going through. They're sad. Their jaws always drooping. And they always have a sad day. But with Christ Jesus and because of all that he's done, this church is on fire. We're walking in power. Yeah. I ain't going to play. I'm going to stop. If this is your first time here today, we want to thank you for coming to Living Life in Victory Church. And that is just not a title. That is the way that we live. We live our lives in victory. I don't care if the doctor give you a bad report. We already know that's a lie. And I'm going to believe what the Lord has already pronounced over my life. I know distractions destroy destinies. Repeat it after me. Say distractions. Destroys. Destiny. So remember that when things come to you that's the contrary, or what happened to my baby sister, I know she won't, but the church already know about it anyway. I just want you to know you're in the best place you could ever be in, because God gonna bless you beyond measure. And I know, and I ain't saying it because you my sister. I'm gonna tell you because it's what the Lord is saying. But my baby Kiana, they got robbed last, was it last week, baby sister? Last Sunday, the devil had the nerve to touch my family. The devil had the nerve to put their hand on my sister like a fool. I said it. He put put his hand on my sister, put a gun to my niece's head, put my baby upstairs, lay her down on the bed, and guess what? The plan of the devil did not work. She's sitting right there. Come here, boo. Come here, boo. Because I want to celebrate my baby living. Because it could have been the other way. She didn't have to be standing here today. Come here, baby sister. Hey, let me love on you. This is what, it's that Family and Friends Day, right? This is what family is about. Even though we go through the things we go through, the trials we go through, people turn their back on us, I can always rely on my family. Ain't that right, Gordon? I don't care what you go through, how bad it seems that your mama don't love you, your daddy don't love you, but let the devil put his hand on your family. Come on now. What you going to do if the enemy put their hand on them children back there, Jada? Daddy, if the devil touch your children, what you going to do to the enemy? You coming for him face to face.
Hey, glory.
And you ain't going to the back door. You going straight. I want you to know, come on over here. You ain't hiding. You ain't, and I ain't going to let you walk around and let you think that the Lord has done something bad. He's setting you up for a blessing. Help me out, church. I ain't never seen the Lord allow the enemy to touch you and he ain't got something big that's on his way. I ain't never seen it. But my baby was going walking the puppy to let the puppy use the bathroom. And the enemy saw fit to watch my sister's house for however long he watched my sister's house. You want to come up here? What Trace did? Would you come over here? You're too far away. And a gun up to your head and you still here to tell a story. A whole lot of folk, Kiana. He said that it was the devil's doing, but can I tell you something? He couldn't go no further than God was going to allow him to go. Hear me good. In your life, he can't go no further than God want him to go. So them being alive today is a true testimony. She got destiny on her life. This distraction came to destroy the destiny. But God avenged my sister and my baby here. Now, when somebody go take you upstairs and lay you down in the bed, the first thing you think you're finna be raped. But God even stopped that
glory,
process.
Glory, glory.
Didn't rape her. Now, I did tell the Lord, I thank God my sister wasn't there. Because we would have probably been having a funeral. Or either in the hospital, because she would have fought. She won't let him take it. Am I telling the truth? Am I telling the truth? You wouldn't let him pull you upstairs with you, because what you would have thought, he going to try to rape you, right? Or even kill you. Even though he said today is the devil's day and it's the devil's work, you still can do what God didn't want you to do. In your life, I don't care where you at and what's going on in your life, if the Lord says no, Satan can give it up. You hear me? I just wanted to bring you up, let you know how much I love you. Your brother-in-law been talking about you all week long. And we're going to bless you today. You watch. Don't you shake your head. It's your season.
Yeah.
And when it's your season, you exit out of a place and you enter into another realm. As a sister and your sister, as a pastor, I kept asking God, what's up? What we doing? You saved the life. Now, what's the full picture? When God wants to get our attention, he know how to get it. Y'all hear it? But you're a blessed woman of God. One day you're going to tell the story just like I tell the story. I'm not saying you're going to preach. All I'm saying is you don't think you can be used of God. I'm telling you that you're going to be used of God. God's going to fill you with his spirit. And he's going to use that bold spirit of yours to come against the enemy, the same devil that came against you. You're going to come against it in other people's lives. Do you hear me? I just want the church, the devil, to see they still here. Woo. Y'all can do better than that for my sister and her daughter.
Hey. Hey. Glory, glory.
You don't want to shame the devil? Say something. Say something. Let him know you still here.
I'm thankful for still being here.
Say what? Say what?
I'm thankful for still being here.
Yeah. Get the mic.
just, it's like my life got twisted.
Uh-huh.
Like I told the young ladies yesterday on my job, it only take a second. 1 minute you turn in a key where you thought it was safe, and the next minute you realize you wasn't safe. I left home at 6:35, and they called me at 7:15 to tell me that he told me he had been watching her. He watched me when I left. But like I told her, it's okay. We still standing.
Yeah.
See, I can say you still standing all I want to, but I need you to tell the devil I'm still standing. And I still got my mind. May felt like I lost it for a minute, but I still got my mind. You may have gone through all that you've gone through, but Sue, you still got your mind. Y'all feel me? You still got your mind. So let's give it up for my sister and my baby, Kiana. All is well. Give me a song. Bam. In your face, devil. In your face. This church is on fire. Y'all may sing that song. I can tell y'all pulling on me to sing that song. But I'm here to do the announcements and visitors. I want to thank you all for being here with me today, with us today. We want to love on you. We have some refreshments after service to bless you. I think all the visitors, as a gift to you all, I think we do. All of you all have raffle tickets today. All the visitors, raise your hand. Your first time visitor, raise your hand. Raise your hand. Do all those visitors have, adults have raffle tickets? They got raffle tickets. Talk to me. Talk to me, church. If they don't, you'll have one in just a few more seconds. Amen. And so our gift to you today, we want you to put your name in the basket. We have a what size TV? Come here, Miss Miranda, because I don't know what it is. Tom. Since we don't have our video announcements, I am your announcer. Hold on.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Friends and Family Day. We are raffling out a 39-inch flat screen TV. Two $15 gift cards and a quilt, and also a t-shirt. So please do not leave before we do the raffle. And God has a word for you. Not here, y'all here by destiny. So God has a word for everyone that's here. So please don't leave. Make sure you use the restroom, use it before the word is spoke, because it's a word in the house for everyone.
Amen. Can we get those that, Minister Jones, make sure those that are ready for the skit, can we get ready for the skit as I do the announcements, please? Thank you. We want to thank you all for coming again. Our services start at 10 o'clock. We have Success School. We have the Fisher's Men class. That's with Pastor Henry.
Amen.
He actually have the men in his area, and they talk and bond and talk about men stuff, so no women can go in the class,
right.
As well as the Women's Grace Mentoring Session. Y'all downplay me. Y'all downplay me. Like, where you at, women? What's up?
Y'all too loud. Can't hear up here.
I'm gonna keep my money in my pocket, baby. I ain't giving no money out. I'm gonna try one more time. And your men didn't do you right. They just sitting there, yeah. Girls who run the world. Yeah. Who run the world. Yeah. Boy, I tell you the truth.
Hold up, baby. Hold up. You want
to
go there?
If I had $1,000 to get away, y'all have lost that money.
Y'all just lost y'all $100 bill. Now,
whoa, 100?
Every man in this room. Where my soldiers at?
Okay.
I rest my case.
They want to play it like
I
that?
I rest my case. You hear what I said?
Jada, they want to go right there?
Ain't nothing they can
do. Okay, ladies, I'm going to give you one more time because they're trying to make it sound as if we ain't got a voice. We ready? What up, girl? Well, bam. I. Girls who run the what? What? Thank you. It's over.
You made me go get my stick.
See, he don't understand that Meriwether won last night because we prayed for him. I'm teasing. Oh, boy. So anyway, our services are every Sunday morning at 10 o'clock a.m. Yeah, take a seat, sir. Praise the Lord. But we do have fun just like this on Sundays. We enjoy each other. It's not church as usual. You know, we get to the word, but also we want you to leave out of here feeling like you came to a place where there's some change. Hit your life. So we have women classes, Grace Mentor, at 9 o'clock a.m. And the Fisherman class is at Pastor Henry area at 9 o'clock a.m. We are here on Tuesdays of a prayer service. We normally have a prophets, our midwife for our church, for our house. Prophets Alisa Gibson. So she's not going to be here this Tuesday because Bishop got her teaching a class on the Holy Spirit at the church, I think all of June, all of August and September as well. So we may have to move our class time maybe to Thursday because she have church on Wednesday. So I want to say all to all of you, we thank you all for being here today. And I think that we are ready. I'm hoping we're ready for our play. We want to help you understand that as a family, we need each other. I don't care what nobody say. You can't make it without family. I know sometimes we feel as if, don't pay them no attention, they're getting ready for the play. And sometimes we feel that mama don't love us, daddy don't love us, sister don't love us, and all that, you know. But in the finality of the day, mama, why you sitting so far back? Why you ain't sitting up here with her? That's my other mama. She all right. She's, that mother, that's Miss Miranda mama. That's my mama, too. She come over here, she mine too. They got a shirt. Amen. Praise the Lord Jesus. And I want to give God praise to Sue, my mother-in-law's best friend. She's here with us today. Sue, stand up and wave your hand. I've been knowing this woman for 30. Pastor and I have been married 32 years next month. I've been knowing her 32 years. That's how long I've been knowing Miss Sue. So thank God for her being here and every other visitor that are here today. We're going to feed y'all and love on you guys and give you a chance to win a television, some other things. You might have some money in the pot. Just never know about in the service. Might be a couple of hundreds in there. I don't know. It's just how I feel. If I feel like giving some more money, I just may give some more money. You feel what I'm saying? This man right here, money man, might go in his pockets and man, give me some money. Yeah. Hallelujah. Are we ready? Are we ready? Got my fruit up there on top of the stage. They're my snacks. They got my snacks on top of the stage. Praise the Lord. Amen. Yeah. Let's turn our attention to drama team.
Who with Brindley, girl? We stay busy, girl. It's time to go. We already cute. We matching. You see y'all? We got to go. So let's get us ready. Come on, girl. Let's go.
You know what? I ain't seen my cousin in so long.
What you doing in my house without calling me?
We family.
I mean, but call me. You know what I could have been doing.
Okay. Well, how are you doing?
Hey, girl, I'm getting ready to go, though. What you ready?
No.
You see my shoes? I'm ready to go.
Because I made an appointment with you. That's sad that I got to make an appointment to see my own
cousin. So Katrina lied to me. Oh,
sure
okay.
Did.
So she told me an appointment with the bishop.
No, not okay. The bishop, baby. Your cousin.
Oh.
Your family.
Well, I'll be better.
I ain't seen the baby.
Okay.
You got married. Okay. You had the little cute little baby.
Can we sit down and talk then?
Yeah, let me get
my goodness.
Let me, can I hold her?
Who's calling me? Hold on.
No, but I just got here.
Wait a minute. Hold on.
Bring.
Hello?
Hey.
What you doing?
I'm getting ready to go, but you know, what you need?
No, look, I need to use the restroom. You need to open the door.
You got some tissue? Because that can cost you, okay?
Man, you better give me one of them baby wet wipes or something. I got to use it. Come on, man.
I mean, no baby wipes ain't... Okay, come on through.
Man, I'm at the door, man. Open the door, man.
You want me to go get it? Come on.
Really, we got to go somewhere. People stopping us. I guess they lied to me because they ain't the real important.
What's up, Cub?
Hey, how you doing?
On?
Where you been?
Man, I've been all right. What you been doing?
Living life, being cute. Hey, that's what we do.
You done got with the little boy. I don't even come around and see you no more. That's what that is. You know how it go.
I got a question. I'm trying to figure out.
Man, what you got to eat in here? I don't know what you're talking about.
Chips.
I'm hungry.
Some Cheetos. I mean, these are Brindley's, but.
That's all you got?
I'm hiding the good stuff.
Wait a minute. Now, pop them over here unannounced. Now, taking my food, too.
You hiding it?
You going to give me?
You got to use my toilet?
For real, these 35 cent bags, keep that, man. I want these.
Oh my God, disrespect. That's why I don't deal with y'all. That's why I don't deal with y'all right now.
No,
oh,
you too good for family?
All I'm saying.
I mean, you move.
Somebody call me. Wait a minute. Car? Wait, Whitney. Golly.
I just wanted to check on my.
Hello?
Brittany, what are you doing?
I'm at the house. What you need, boo?
Honey, I need my hair done, babe. I need my hair done.
Well, Ava, you, it's a really great time to ask me that. What you need to do?
I'm going
to
come over there. I'm already outside, so I'm going to come in the house and come by.
Ava,
was that Ava?
That was Ava.
Babe, I ain't seen Ava in years.
I mean, she down the street. When you ain't never called the girl. Ava, I can't fix this right now.
Babe, I need my Pocahontas done.
Brittany, what? I know could in jail walk in here and then you speak, just sit down.
That's just what I'm dealing with, y'all.
What, that's some Peruvian? What is that? That's some yakki, ain't it?
Oh, my God.
Ooh, wee.
Don't call for her.
Man, who hit you, the Matrix?
Are you wet?
Man.
Change your pamper again.
Don't call for her.
Let's stop for a second. Wait a minute. So I had an appointment with a bishop. No, it was really you.
Yes. Hallelujah.
The devil always uses somebody.
No. I came as an angel.
He used Hallelujah. You. That's why you got her.
I got married. And see, y'all just hate. So you know what? It's my own deal with y'all. Right, y'all man. Mad because y'all mad because I got upgraded. You see that 10K on my fingers and these tinkers on my toes and my nails. And y'all mad because you ain't got no man, you ain't got no kids, no house. So y'all just jealous and you mad because I got a better house than you. So man, come on through.
First of all, I got a man. His name is Jesus.
That's cold, right?
I was your family.
That's cold.
I was your cousin. I was your boo before you got a boo. So don't forget about me.
That's because God had you in place to keep me stationary until he brought me my real boo.
Hold on now. One more thing. Your house might be better than mine, but I gave my life to Christ, and I'm doing things the right way, so it's kind of hard.
I guess you're right.
When
I mean,
you're working
I'm trying to be
hard.
Shady, now. I'm just saying. I feel like y'all in my house unannounced. You need your hair done. You need some restroom. You unannounced.
I'm just upset because I haven't seen my family in like 3 years.
I know.
Well, I guess you forgot how y'all treated me when I was a kid.
I ain't forgot that.
I'm about to call my auntie Lori because, baby, y'all ain't finna play me.
Y'all don't forget how y'all treated me when I was a kid.
You know, I really think it's time for
I mean, I love y'all, but I feel like it's been shade since I was a kid.
No, it ain't no shade, girl. We just haven't seen you in a long time.
Y'all call me, oh, stinky, wiki, Brittany coming through. I hated that.
You see this? I'm about to call her. Then you see I'm calling your mama.
Don't call her. You know she crazy. Don't call her.
I'm calling the big dogs, okay?
We can all get prayed for.
Hello?
Hey, T. Lori. How you doing?
Sweetie.
Hey. I just was really thinking about you. You know, I had to pop up on your daughter because she really, really has been trying me because I haven't seen her in 2 months. You know,
remember, prayer changes things, baby. Have you prayed about it?
I mean...
What she say? Pray about it.
I tell you what. Little do you know.
Your mama, girl.
But little do you know, I'm right outside the door.
You right outside?
She in my house, too?
I'm right outside the door.
I'm finna go.
Hold on. Wait a minute. Don't leave me with her. You know she.
Big dog.
Wait a minute. Let's go, Brenda. We finna go,
Brenda. Get your baby. I'm finna go.
Can't eat the microphone, Brenda.
Hey. What's up?
No, you can't leave. I ain't seen you.
What's up? I feel tension in the house. Quiet.
Can I start? First of all, she came here unannounced. He used the restroom to eat my food, and she her hair done last minute. I can't fix that dude up right now. I mean, I have to go somewhere. I guess it wasn't the truth, but you know, still, I'm ready. I can go get something to eat.
It seems as if prayer can fix it for you.
Pray about the unannouncements?
Prayer.
Let me get on my knees.
Why can't I pray about the unannouncements?
Prayer is the most you can do.
Y'all got to pray. Look.
Pray.
So prayer gonna make her pick up the phone.
Can't fix it for you,
don't
baby.
Don't come for me.
She ain't
besides, now
I'm gonna
go up there. Don't mess with me.
Let me tell you. Maybe the Lord gave you a divine family reunion.
Here it go.
Maybe he sent people to your door to knock at the door so that you can recognize that you need your family, and just not your husband.
Your family. Mm.
Now, I love my son-in-law. He's a great man. He's a good boy. I love him. But sometimes you're going to need family. You may need a babysitter. Your husband may need a babysitter. But you
got
to put your affections toward the Lord. You don't even go to church hall like you used to. You got married. You stop coming to church. You stop praying. I believe this is a divine encounter that your cousin, your brother, everybody has showed up at the same time. I just believe that we need to have a family reunion.
Family reunion. There you go. Come on. Where the music at?
Hi.
Lights, please. Lights,
hey.
Please.
Hey. Crank it up, baby. Come on, man. You and the baby. I ain't dancing with y'all. Come on.
Yes.
You get it. Come on, show me them heels. Hold on, this is the wrong song for this. That's why we don't bring you to church. That's why we leave you at home, because you ratchet.
I mean, but you told me to be me. You're coming to see me. What? The next time we see each other. Can you hold Brindley, because you're a little heavy. Maybe years and years from now.
Lights off, please. Keep that moving, please. Lights.
Lord, it's so good to see the whole family together. Thank you, my dear.
I tried. I used my pistol for some of them because that's all they understood. I had to threaten half of them here. Ruben, 96, she needed to see all her family, you know? I'm thirsty. Baby, get us some lemonade out the house, please.
Yes, ma'am.
They told me she was a handful. How you get her to be so polite?
I've been tearing that ass up. No, you know, I look at all these foster parents taking these children in, you know, just trying to get money. But you know what I found out? Ain't nothing wrong with these children. All they need is some love and support and somebody to be a little patient with them, and they'll be all right. You know, that's what I found out about these kids. Nigga, didn't I tell you to get the hell off that telephone? What is your problem? I told you to hang up Aunt Ruby's phone. I'm gonna take that phone and shove it so far down your throat. All you're gonna be able to do is dial 911 with your neighbor. Do you hear me? Get the hell in the house and hang up the phone. Put it on the hook. Gotta be patient with these babies, you know? Lord.
Is that Victoria?
Lord, have mercy. Who wear heels to a family reunion? Hello.
Hello, ladies. It's warm out today, isn't it?
Be cool if you had on some regular clothes. That's a nice dress, Victoria.
Thank you.
It's kind of hot, isn't it?
It's all the rave in Paris.
Well, this is hot Georgia. It's not Paris. So we don't wear dressy like that. You look silly. Trying to be so bougie. Wee wee, pee pee.
Where is everyone?
She's going to need some deodorant.
Wee wee.
Wee wee. For her booty.
Second clip, please.
Good Lord, who they came to? Who that man? Oh, I'm finna go.
Second clip.
I'm ready to go. Should we come back and pray for it?
Okay, so who's gonna plan the family reunion?
I mean, I guess I will. I mean, I'm the better planner. I mean,
well.
Well, I'm going to apologize for being so rude to y'all, because I felt like y'all was coming for me. But, you know, it was just my own insecurities, and, you know, I was being bougie, because I felt like I had arrived.
As long as you don't play pop shaker music the whole family reunion, I will calm.
But let me, okay.
And no church music all day.
You want some chillings?
Chillings?
Y'all want chillings?
No.
You know I'm down to eat now.
Y'all want my fried chicken?
Some greens.
Because I can bake it really good, too. You want?
I want some salmon croquette.
You want some salmon croquette? Oh, I can do salmon. Okay, so let's do one in about 2 months. Okay, let me plan about 2 months. Is that okay?
I think we should be different and do it in like October, you know.
My baby yanking up. Let me get her. No. Let's go. I know, baby. It's all right. She can't do nothing.
Well, look, I'm going to let y'all do y'all thing. I'm finna go. I got to go back to work. I done got over here.
I love y'all.
See y'all later.
Find himself just for me. Lord. I've not only been blessed, I have been divinely favored.
It's so true. You know, Myrtle, I weep for these young women today. Some of them will never know that. In fact, never know even a portion of what you're talking about. Darlings, love is many things. It's varied. One thing it is not and can never be is unsure.
Take me outside. I want to be with my family.
Church on Sunday morning, Grandma's hand played a tambourine so well. Grandma's hand.
Oh. Almost hit it. You must be Carlos.
Is that obvious?
Yeah, a little bit. I'm Brian, Lisa's cousin. How you doing? Come on, I'll introduce you to everybody. Baby snakes there in that grass, Grandma's hand.
Frankie.
I know who you are.
Mom, I was hoping that we could talk for a minute.
I can't talk to you now, dear. I'm talking to your sister about something more important. Lisa. Lisa.
Singing and dancing and thanking God, giving him the glory. Thanking him for getting us over. As we marched up the road this afternoon, what we saw were young men gambling, fighting, cussing. Women with no clothes on, gyrating all over on this land. Do you see this shack? The man and woman who were born here gave birth to this generation. They were slaves. They work this ground. But they bought it from the widow of the slave owner. And that's the kind of blood we have running through our veins. That's the stock that we are made of. What happened to us? What happened to us? I mean, who are you? Do you know who you are? What happened to the pride and the dignity and the love and respect that we had for one another? Where did it go? And how do we get it back? I'ma tell you. Young black men, take your place.
Come on.
We need you.
Yes.
Your sons and daughters need you. Did you understand what I just said? You were sold off and had no choice. Yes, but now it's time to stay. Take your place. Now. Starting now. Starting now. Young black women, you are more than your thighs and your hips. You are beautiful, strong, powerful. I want more from you. Take your place. I want every single one of you, young man, young woman, turn to the next person standing alongside of you. Grab them and hug them and tell them that you love them. Tell them if you need anything, come to me. If you need somebody to talk to, come to me.
I love you, girl.
I'll give you the shoulder. I'll give it a hug. I'll feed you. I'll clothe you if you need it. That's how you start. From this moment, when you leave this reunion today, you take that with you. God bless you all.
God bless you.
Just take your neighbor and hug your neighbor. Just hug your neighbor. Hug him.
Lord.
Hug your neighbor.
Amen. Oh, this is beautiful. This is beautiful. Nothing like a good hug. Nothing like a good hug. Y'all enjoyed that scene? Yeah. We got a hand praise. I don't know about you, but I saw a lot of good things and a lot of messages in that short film, of that portion of that film. And I feel God in this room. I feel family in this room. We thank you for the things you've done and what you're doing right now. God, we thank you for the lives that have been spared even last night. I thank you for the things you're going to do on tomorrow morning. But God, while we're here in this place, we don't take it lightly. We trust you in this hour, God, because the things you're going to show us and give us in our destiny call, we bless your name, but you are our King, and we reverence you, Lord God. You are Lord, and you are master of our destiny. We bless you, Lord God, for the unction you have in us to push us to our next level. I thank you for these women and these men and these children in this room, Lord. They didn't come out just for a gimmick, God. They came out because there's something that you have in store for them. And I thank you, Lord God. It's not by chance or we did it in our own effort. It's because you summons your people. And you yet summoning the people around this country to find a church home or find a place or find something that connect with them and connect you with them, Lord God, and it's the church. We give you praise for it. In Jesus' name. Everybody say.
Amen.
Everybody say.
Amen.
Glory to God. That's what I'm talking about. I saw a lot of good points in that video, sweetheart. Very good points concerning family. I thank God for Living Life Victory. We do that once a year. Family, once a year. We try to engraft people in here. We might offer a television or we might offer things. I know that's one way of doing it. But and before you get to that point, we want to share with you the gospel. We want to share with you the things, what we believe in and why we do a thing. And God has always established from the beginning of time family.
Yeah.
Family has been on God's mind, his heart, and when he created man and woman.
Yeah.
And so I'm not going to be here long, but I want to share with you some things that I was sitting in my office last night, and while the team was watching the fight, I came in my office, and I began to do some study, some research, and some things that I believe that it's going to bless you today. So say it with me, family has always been on God's heart. It's always been on God's heart. And so while I was studying out, he led me to the book of Genesis. In the book of Genesis, chapter 2, New King James Version. Start with me if you have your Bibles, if you have your iPads or your smartphone. Go with me, New King James Version, to verse 8, Genesis chapter 2. While I was reading this, keep in mind where I'm going to. I had pondered on this for a long time, for matter of fact, for some years, and it hit me last night. So our goal was to talk about families. So God always wanted to institute family. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 8, and the Lord planted a garden in the eastward of Eden. And there he put man whom he had formed. And out of the ground the Lord had made every tree to grow is pleasant to the sight and good for food. And the tree of life was also in the midst of the garden, and in the tree of knowledge and good and evil. Jump down to verse 15. Do you see it?
And the Lord took man, watch this, young people. And the Lord took man and put him in the garden to and keep it. And the Lord, and hold on a second. And the Lord, God commanded the man, saying, of every tree of the garden you may eat freely, but the tree of knowledge of good and evil you shall not eat of it. For the day that you eat of it, you shall surely die. Y'all see that? And the Lord said, it is good. Watch this now. I'm going to rock your boat. And the Lord said, it is good that man should not be alone. And I stopped right there. It's not good for man to be alone. So I kind of like play with it in my own little natural mind. It's not good for man to be by himself. It's not good for a woman to be by himself. It's not good. It's not good that y'all do it by yourself. Y'all listen to me. It's not good. The Bible says it's not good for you to do this all by yourself. Y'all feel me so far? It's not good. It ain't good. You leave a man by himself, he'll mess things up. Leave a woman by himself, he needs some help. I'm working on something. He said, I will make him a helper compatible to him. And out of the ground, watch this now. I'm reading this, but then verse 19 switches the subject. And out of the ground, the Lord created and formed beasts of every field of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to Adam to see what he would call them. Whatever Adam called every living creature, that was his name. Watch this. Now it switches again. And so Adam gave names to all the cattle and birds in the air and every beast of the field. But Adam, there was not found a helper compatible to him. God created all the animals. And when he made the animals, listen to this now. Adam named the animals. Verse 21. So now, God created these animals. He brings them to Adam to see what he will call them. Listen to this now. Gonna bless you. In the process of time, God was working on something with Adam. I'm gonna create you somebody for you. Before I do that, I'm gonna give you something to work with. So he creates these animals, and then he names every animal, cow, horses, you know, apes, you name it. He named all the animals. And when he named the animals, the Bible says, verse 21, and the Lord caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs and close up of his flesh in his place. Then the rib which the Lord God had taken from man, he made unto him a woman, and he brought her to the man. What do you see what you don't see? Come on, young people. What you see and you don't see. God brought all the animals to Adam. After he made Adam, he put him in the garden to keep it. First thing he had to do was to take care of the trees and the trees and the foliage. But God wanted us to be, he wanted us to have dominion. He wanted us to rule. Watch this, y'all. He wanted us to rule. So what are we going to rule? Trees? We're going to rule the flowers and grasses? No. He created these animals. He created all the animals, then he names the animals. But he did not name the woman yet. Why was that? Stay with me. And he said, verse 23, this is bone of my bone, Pastor Lori. Flesh of my flesh, Pastor Lori. She shall be called who? Woman. Because she is taken out of man. Therefore, here's the first marriage. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, they shall become flesh. Oh, I can play with this right here, or I can play with this. Oh, I have been thought, I have heard so many times when a woman leaves, no, it said when a man, God, y'all, this is revelation. When a man leaves his father and mother, not when a woman, when can I stay right there and move on to something else? Because y'all gonna make me work hard. You're gonna make me work hard. I wasn't trying to work this hard. I want to go home and look at Pastor Laura and get something to eat. Glory to God. So he creates animals and he brings them to Adam to name them. Go to chapter 3. You know the story. Woman was tempted. He talked about the woman in verse 1. He talked about how the serpent came and the woman to do all that. She ate the fruit and they ate the fruit and they realized it was naked. Okay, it goes all the way down. Go with me to verse 11. Because you know they've been caught, they realized they've been exposed. He said, "Who told you were naked?" And they were eating. Have you eaten from the tree which I command you that you should not eat? And the man said, "The woman you gave me, she gave me of the tree, and I ate it." And the Lord said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" Had the woman that was deceived. If you read some more, if you come on down, come on down. I'm working on something. Where is it, Lord? Where did I see it at? Where did I see it at? All right, here we go. Verse 17, and Adam said, "Because you have eaten of the voice of your wife, you have eaten from the tree of knowledge. I command you, saying, you should not eat of it." If you read on the rest of this, verse 20 is the kick. All this time, he's been talking about the woman. He never gave her name. But in verse 20, he says this, and Adam called his woman Eve. All this time, he named all the animals, but he didn't give them a name. He didn't name the woman until after they sinned. Why? Because man was supposed to rule over animals and not over women. Now man has rule over woman because of sin. It wasn't the intent that a woman be ruled over. Because of sin, now he has to give her a name. So if you name someone, oh, watch this. This is my son. He was born by my wife. He's a child. I gave him his name. I will always be ruled over him. But even when they get to a certain age, this respect comes in place. But over a period of time, a child knows who the mom is. I'm over this. You ain't running nothing. I pay the bills here. I'm in authority here. And that's what happened in the Garden of Eden. When a woman ate the fruit and gave it to her husband and they sinned, she lost her authority. Now the family has been twisted. Family has been, this is where it all started. Family has been twisted because of what happened in the garden. Woman was never supposed to be ruled over. They had equal authority. Woman had the same. If you read your Bible in verse in Genesis chapter 1, God talks about how he let us make man in our own image and let them rule over the fishes in the sea. Look at your Bible. He said in the beginning, let them rule. Woman lost her rulership when he ate the fruit and gave to the man. Even though the Bible said he gave authority to the man, yes. So when he ate it, now the woman has submitted under to him now. Now, family right then has been twisted. The enemy wanted to twist family way back then, but he thought he had us. God, y'all making me work too hard. Y'all making me work too hard. So I'm looking at this thing. Too many people say, let's not shove the Bible down our children's throats. Okay, I hear that and I see that. It's evident in you watch the news, you watch the television, you see the rebellious nation. We hear millennials, the word millennials. We see this new age thing. We see all this what's happening with this new generation. It's like they're out of control. Yeah. Matter of fact, they joining churches that glory to God that just don't make sense. The foundation is already warped. They rebel against mom and dad. I'm grown now. What happened to this? What happened to the submitting of an authority? Authority got lost in the garden because of a piece of fruit. It wasn't no apple. I can go deeper than that. You really want me to do some research on you? Some of y'all never heard me preach before? I can show you. But I don't have time for it. What kind of fruit it was? You asked that question, what kind of fruit it was? Did anybody know? Y'all know we talked about this before. I love to know. Pastor, can you just go say about the fruit? Family has been twisted. This generation has been out of hand because a rebellious spirit is roaming in the country. It wants the woman to stand up against the man. Like, you can't tell me what to do.
Talk.
Oh, yes, I can. I pay the bills. I got a job, too. And I pay bills. Now, whoa. That wasn't supposed to be that way. I make more money than you. Okay, what you said, baby? You make more money. We'll tell them. Well, they hit the road then.
Don't come back. And you hit the road.
You be like, what did I just do?
Come on.
God never intended families to argue like this. And that's what's happening. The world wants us to argue and spit us up. And cause us not to be one. So I'm reading my Bible and I'm studying. I'm hearing God about things concerning this culture, and I live this culture. I work for the government. I see things, and it disturbs me how out of hand this country has come to. And it starts in the home. Y'all heard it before. Y'all been in church before. You heard it before.
It starts in the home.
You not saying nothing. You let it go on in your house. No, you are the one in authority, but you let it go on. I'm not gonna shut about the Bible down. We all
five different churches in the same house.
Jeez. See, I said that again in English.
Pastor.
A family of five go to five different churches. You go to Mount Pleasant, you go to Mount Eve, you go to St. Augustus, you go to Baptist Pentecostal Tabernacle, you go to St. Advance Saturday Service, the Jewish Custom Church. We all over the place. So you can't hear my authority because you're hearing other things. You can't hear the pastor's authority because you're all over the place. That's not what it's supposed to be. Y'all heard me before, and from y'all didn't hear me before. We at home eating our own mind, eating our dinner in the house, and you upstairs eating your dinner, you downstairs in your den eating your dinner. We don't know what's going on. Baby, something wrong with Joe. You don't. Back in the day, mama used to make us come to the table. And that's what family again to share the things going on in the house with issues that you cannot handle. That's what family do. Family, what you said, baby? Family don't leave family hanging.
Talk.
Y'all listen to me this morning. I'm trying to get something out. And I'm looking at how our family has been warped by the system that we allow in our house. Well, because we didn't push the Bible down their throats. Let them be. You know, I don't believe in that. I'm going to stay home and drink my beer, okay? I ain't going to push the word on them. But if you don't push the word on your children, the world will push the word on the children. And that's what has happened with these millennials. What you said yesterday, what millennials mean? It means what? Rebellion. I'm a millennial. You are? You need some order, baby. We have disrespected order. And honor.
Teach.
I have seen so much chaos in the last 20 days with these riots.
Talk.
And a lot of those people are all out of order because what's in their heart, because we didn't push the Bible in them.
Talk.
What the Bible said? Raise your child. What the Bible said? Train them up. We're not doing that. We don't want to do that. No, leave them alone. Don't be teaching them to my son, to my daughter. And when they get up old enough, they tell you what to do.
Talk.
I went to a store one day. I will never forget this. My day travel. I was in the store one day. It was recently. I was minding my own business, going, taking, running to Edmund Pastelory. And I saw this kid. Mama, leave me alone. Matter of fact, I want that right there. And if he don't get it, he gets to cry. Now, here was the thing that disturbed me the most. Some of our grown people act like children. They don't even know who they are. We just like this. I heard the scenario. When a man or woman don't get what they want, because they haven't had training and order in the house, we acting like we on the ground kicking just like the babies. Can't have what we want. I want that car. Can I have that car? I want that. No, you can't. We're not ready for the car yet. We gotta manage some things. I want that truck. Give me my truck. Children, men, grown folk acting like kids. You want that woman. You won't do women. You just met him.
T. Come on in here, Pastor.
What is this generation? I'm learning something for myself. What is the generation where the first time you meet somebody, you already in the bed with them? What's going on with this? You just met the man. Where is the home training at?
Come on, Pastor. Stay in there, baby.
Brother be trying to get them digits. I gotta get them digits. What's that? That's old school. Y'all know what digits. It's the phone number, young folks. Kevin, it's the telephone number. I tried my best to get her number. How we said my nose up in the air back in the day? I can smell her coming. And she would give me her number. And I follow her around. This is some of y'all, we follow her around. And finally, she just gave me a conversation. And that was my day. And that's how we used to do it.
It's all, baby. Come on.
But now, you just met the guy on the stoplight. You in the stop sign. Hey, what's up, baby? What's up? Hey, what you doing right now? I'm going on with. Come on the side. Let me talk to you. You don't know he was a mass murderer?
Talk. All right now.
I've seen a lot of child molesters in my day. But now it's out of hand. Give your children a foundation.
Teach.
It's not too late.
Simply
give them some Jesus. What, Pastor? Bring them to church on Sunday.
That's right.
Come to Sunday school, Sunday success school, and hear the word on Sunday before you preach. You never know. There's something going to catch. I remember when Pastor Laura got together with those kids across the street, they couldn't even quote nothing about the Bible. Matter of fact, she taught them the Ten Commandments. Yes, it's Old Testament. Yeah, nothing wrong with that. But they didn't even know that because they could quote. Listen to this now. I seen kids quote stuff from R&B songs and remember it by heart. Ask one of them to quote Psalm 23. Excuse me, what is that? What are the Psalms? They don't know what Psalms is because we're not pushing it down their throat. We letting the world push it down their throat.
Jeez.
And I'm going home after this. It got so bad now, it's common to see two women hugging and kissing.
You in the house.
It's common to see two men, and I throw up when I see that. Two men. That's horrible. And every channel you turn to now, even on a good show, it's got to have something in there. Because we didn't push the word down their throat. I'm telling you this morning, before we leave out, don't let the world raise your kids. Don't let the world train your children. Ain't no such thing as no man came from no ape. The Bible simply tells you how it began. And God created man in his own image. It said, none of what, and then God said, Adam, you name. God gave Adam wisdom to name animals. He named the ape. So how did we become an ape?
That's good.
The man named the ape. The ape didn't name the man.
That's good.
But that's what but political world has said. When God created man, he made Adam and Steve. But this Bible don't say it. Not on my watch. I hope I don't mean to offend nobody, but that ain't gonna fly here. I love on you. If you got some issues within that area, I'm gonna love on you. I don't want you to leave and walk away and don't come back. I'm gonna love on you because there's some identification things going on in here. The world has taught you to change your identity. And God said, I made man, gave him authority, and I made woman, gave him authority. But what's happened, it has got diluted and twisted, and we don't read our Bible to see what the Bible says about an issue. When a man, when a child gets out of hand, the Bible said, beat them. Oh, I didn't mean to say it like that. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. You don't hit your kids. You hear me, son? What's up, brother? What's up, man? I like you. Tell them again, brother. You don't. And say, guess what? Guess what? I'm about to go home. Y'all want me with her. If you whip your child in public and somebody sees you, you may. They gonna somebody gonna tell it and write your tag number down. They live so and so, and they gonna come to your house. But guess what they do in school? They gonna whoop your kids in school. It's okay for them to do it. I promise you all, we need to get on our faces. The Bible said, "Prayer of a righteous man availeth much." But it's not veiling much because we're not doing it in our houses. You pray over your children before they go to school on that bus. I see more school bus fighting than I don't want to see. I see more girls fighting. It's almost like, what has happened to our culture? Is that the thing now, to fight? I saw a young lady the other day, Travis. I saw, and I was minding my own business. I always mind my own business, but I be seeing stuff. Be trying to mind my own business, but I be seeing. I saw this nice young lady come out the store. Was it Garden Ridge? It wasn't Garden Ridge, it's over there on Summer. Nice young lady. She came out the store, and I saw another lady coming behind her. But it was a lady, but her pants, she had her pants like a man, and it was hanging down, and she was walking like. I said, And then she did it publicly. Listen now, she kissed the girl in the street before she got. They kissed each other like. The world is bold enough to do what they do. Are we bold enough to stand on what we believe in? We're scared. Don't send them in work. Don't send them on Jesus. Man, I'll tell you something. If they bold enough to say something to me on the spot, I got you now, brother. I'm going to say something about Jesus in front of you. Because I always, it happens. We won't say nothing. If they open that door, well, Pastor, I don't know the word like you do. God will give you. He will open up your mind something to say about what you don't agree with. If they open that door up, hey, amen. You want to see the booth? Come on, sweetheart. Hold up. Sit down. I want to do something. I want to introduce you to Miss Universe, Miss Tennessee, Pastor Lori Lavender. Hey, come on. Oh!
He just want me to cook this evening, that's all that is.
Yes, I am.
I just wanted to add, about maybe 3 minutes, I just want to add Luke 6:45. Can we get that up on the screen, please? Good word, Pastor, love that. I just want to, since you're talking to the men and talking about how God gave men the authority, I want to let the women know that we took our authority back when we gave our life to Jesus Christ. And then we submitted up under the order of our spouses. But I want you to know that you got to know what tree you fell from. Even though they ate off the wrong tree and ate the wrong fruit, the blood of Jesus set us back in right standing with God so that we can eat off the right fruit and people can eat from our lives. Amen? As a woman, if you don't know who you are, then you hook up with people that know who they are, so what's on them can get on you, and then we can reproduce the authority in the earth that God set in order for us to walk in. Okay? Now, this is not rebutting what Pastor's saying. I'm just helping those. You know, when a house is out of order, most of the time the woman is out of order. If Pastor Henry decides that he's going to backslide and go and be with another woman, which I pray he never does.
In the name.
Y'all hear that?
Y'all ain't hear that.
I just pray he don't ever go that route. It just won't be good for him. Because his mama going to beat him first, and I'm going to get him.
Yeah, he will.
The thing is that good communication can corrupt. I mean, bad communication can corrupt. Good morals, good standards. When you decide, because, you know, we don't let men find us no more, we find them. going to help you out before we leave. I'm going to give you 2 or 3 minutes of this thing. And so it says, are we at 6:45? It says a good man. Can we go to message version on that, please? Let's go to message. I know I'm got y'all all over the place. But my thing is this. If you don't know who you are as a woman in submission under the authority of your home, if you don't know who you are, 9 times out of 10, you're going to cause the family or your spouse or your children to eat the fruit of deception. So the way I feel is the way I'm going to run my house. You can't run your home by your feelings. We're women and we're up today, we're down tomorrow. Tomorrow we're on the left side of the field, the next side we're on south side, the next side we're on east side, then we're on west side. Our feelings take us all over the place and we can't figure out where we are or what we're doing. But when you understand what God has placed on the inside of you as a woman, when you begin to walk as a woman of grace, a woman of wisdom, a woman of worth, a woman of worth, knowing who you are, I'm going to leave a little tag on him. You can't be for sale to every man. You begin to put yourself on a clearance rack, and you begin to devalue who you are. So when dude shows up, you don't know who he is because you all jacked all up in your spirit. And so, I know it's him. I have a feeling. That's the problem. You in your feelings. That's what's up. You in your feelings. You know, I just feel like this is, I've been going through for 5 years and I haven't had a man in my life in 5 years. So you're going to create your own man. So you go to work, let him stay at home while you go to work.
Whoa. You went there. You went there.
See, in our generation, big bro Mike. What's up, Mike? What's up, Mike? What's up, dude? That's my big brother Mike. So what we do, we flip the script, Mr. Rowland. We don't let the man get you come here, baby, and get
you
down on your knee.
I'm coming right now.
You get down, propose to me, baby.
We get on down.
Instead of you getting down, proposing to him, proposing to you, the role switches. We ain't gotta do it like everybody else do it. Will you marry me? When you put yourself down below a man, boy, I hate these kids in here right now. I can't say what I want to say. When you put yourself down that low, you'll go for anything.
Oh, that's rich. My God, my God.
Why are you going to devalue yourself, put yourself on the clearest rack, and mark yourself down? You're going to lower your standards because you don't know the value of your worth.
My Lord.
And so guess what? Some men like that. Not you, baby. Oh, no, sir. No, you a strong man. Praise the Lord. So what I'm saying is we reverse in this season and the era of our lives. Mike, we reversing roles. I do not want to be him. I need to be all that I can be to me. I need to know who I am so I can help my daughters recognize who they are in the spirit realm, okay? Okay, Luke 6, it says, this is the Amplified version, you don't get wormy apples off a healthy tree, nor good apples off a diseased tree. The health of an apple tells the health of the tree. You must begin with your own life, living, giving lives. It's who you are, not what you say or do, that counts. Your true being brims over into true words of thee. What that saying is, you speak well of me. He said he loved you, but he beat you to death. You say you love me, but you talk bad to me, talk down to me, call me B's, call me H's, you call me MF's, you call me all that, but you say you love me, but your actions. But your actions of a man. A man can't go no farther than we allow them to go. If you talking bad to me now before I marry you, 9 times out of 10. It's going to get bad once I marry you. Because now guess what? Your name, Thomas or whatever that it is, gives you authority to say, sit yourself down, get yourself up. And you know us women, oh, he want me to do this. Oh, he want me to do this right here. Oh, he said I wasn't this. He said I wasn't that. What you say about yourself? So what I'm saying to you is this, women, says Pastor, I want to talk to y'all. Your grace to be who you are. Everything you need to become the woman that God has created you to be is already built inside of you. That's the reason why he put the man to sleep here to do a real special operation on brother.
So when he come out, you can name her queen. You ain't got to call her whore. She can name her queen and she ain't got to be your B. That's wow. all I'm saying. We living in the world the kids know because they see it, they hear it all the time. They love phones that we buy our children in this world. We give them the telephones. They see everything. But we got to get to a place where we got to say enough is enough. Mm. I'm not going to marry you. I ain't finna hook up with you until you can become the man of God that you need to be. God, Adam had to become the man of God to be to that woman. I don't want to marry no man that don't know who he is. If you ain't praying before I marry you, doggone it, you sure ain't going to pray once we get married. All I'm saying is, why stay with somebody or be with somebody if he don't help you pay bills before you marry him? 9 times out of 12 tens, he ain't gonna pay bills when you marry him. If he talk against your family now, you ain't seen nothing once you get married. You need family. You can't live without family. I don't care what you say. If I haven't seen you in 12 years, when your date comes to go see Jesus, everybody gonna show up at the funeral.
Hallelujah.
I may need your hug that day, your condolences that day, but one way or another, Mike, we need each other.
Glory to God.
But we can't communicate with each other like we need to because we're so hooked up and tied up to something else that ain't, you know, hooked up with God. So I'm going to help some of you. If you want to decide you want to get married, make sure he can lead you to Jesus first.
Make sure.
Please. If he ain't serving in church, don't you serve him. Because a man don't serve, God won't serve you.
Rich.
You don't hear me? Now, the word tells that a woman's supposed to submit herself to a man, but the Bible really says that we are to submit ourselves to each other. I want to serve you. I don't want to be made to serve you. It's my honor to serve Pastor Henry. Yeah. It's my honor when he walk in the house and open a refrigerator door and I've already cooked something
already cooked.
He decides he wants something different and he says to him, "Man, I sure really want me a sandwich." Uh-huh. And in my mind, I'm going around to, "Well, dude, I don't cook. You need to go and eat them poke meats whatever I done made for you." Look at Mr. Rowe. So, I sit in the room, brother. I go in the room and say, "Man, this man want a darn sandwich, and I done cook this." And then he'll walk back again, and he'll look at me. "I sure want a sandwich."
I'll be working. I'll be...
But the 21st century woman said, "Make your own sandwich."
See?
The women long time ago would have already, before he first said it, he didn't want to make that sandwich. We've got to find out who we are and what season and what time that we're in. We can't continue to let people speak crazy in our ears and think you're going to come out on a success end of the stick. It ain't going to happen. If a guy tells you, we can live together, let's try out, you know, you're going to put me on a 90-day layaway plan? You're going to put me on a 90-day layaway plan to see if we're going to make it. We ain't going there. I'm not doing it. Because I remember the time he and I got ready to live together. Yeah, we tried to live together. We did. We went and got the apartment, paid the deposit, and got ready to live together. And the day that we got ready to move in, that a small, still voice said, "If you move in with him, he ain't got to marry you. Because he already got what he want. So why he's going to commit to you?" I went up there and told her, "Like, get my money back." But now, even though the Lord was talking to me in a place, he was talking to him too. He said, "Babe, we don't need to live together. We got to do it right." Now, it took us 8 years to get it together. But at least we got it together, a long time. But at least we got it together. There is no need you continue in relationship that you know are depleting you. Are depleting you and you think it's going to get any better because he loved me. Love don't pay your utility bill. It does not pay the mortgage payment. Y'all gonna come back and visit us again. I'm a realist. I want to help you make it to the next place of success. If you want a successful relationship, do the things that's gonna make you have a successful relationship. Make qualitative decisions over your life and your money. If he broke now, don't marry nobody that don't have a job.
Don't marry what?
I'm not saying you can't marry him. I'm just saying, baby, let's get a job first. Let's get somebody to help us with our finances and show us how to save some money. Me and him got married with 4 jobs. How crazy was that? 4 jobs. He had 3, I had 1. So tell me, how are we to start a marriage, a new marriage, and nobody's at home? You working 3 jobs. That's out the will of God. That's why you can't raise the kids, because you out working 3 jobs and he ain't working. At home watching TV. Walk you to the door, kiss you and get in the car, baby, have a good day. You got to decide that if you want to marry somebody, become the best man you could possibly be. And I'm not saying that you're going to be perfect. There is no perfect people. From bishops to the pope to the pastors to whatever, there are no perfect people. We live the best life that we can possibly live. The word of God would help us walk the way we need to walk. I'm not saying you're not going to trip up, but we do have something called grace and some mercy. We can fall 77 times in a day, and God will restore us back to the fold. That's the mercy of God. So I'm finished. That's all I want to say to the ladies. Find out who you are. Birth your family out through prayer. A prayerless woman will see nothing. You'll see nothing that you want to see but your children. And even though your mother didn't pour into your life, you can still turn around for your children and for your life. Thank you.
Amen. We have 4 minutes to finish this up, and we're going home. Man, Pastor Lord, you hit on a lot of good points. Well, another thing about families, I want y'all to remember, it's not happened to you all, but y'all may have seen it, that because your family is together at the house and you working 3 or 4 jobs, you develop a new relationship at work with somebody else. Right. And you find a lot of workplace involvement in sneaking around in my day, which is tipping and dipping, and, you know,
dipping.
And slipping. But that's what's happening, and this is normal. Because the house is not home.
Right.
It's a house, but it's not home. And you find yourself, what's wrong with my husband? No, he don't kiss me like he used to.
Talk.
Somebody he talking to, maybe, I don't know. But I'm praying that that doesn't happen. If it is happening, we're going to stop it today. So I'm going to ask you all, I don't know what's happening in your house. I don't know if anything is out of order. I don't know if the kids are out of line. I don't know this. But today is family and friends day. So I'm going to ask you to stand on your feet. I don't know if the bills not paid. I don't know all that. But I do know there is a reason and a purpose why God brought you here this morning.
Yes.
Glory to God. I don't know if you didn't cook for your husband last night or she didn't bring you your flowers. I don't know. And there might be something you want that didn't happen in your way, so you kicking up like a kid. And the family is, God instituted family in the beginning. And all of a sudden now, the language of family has been changed. It's we don't know what is family now, because you got other people who are raising your children that are not of the same sex. Father, I thank you that these men and these women in this room are here, oh God, for change in their homes. Some of them having problems, some of them not having problems. But those who have issues, they cannot fix. I ask you, Lord God, that your hand, your silent angel on that family. Touch that husband who's doing everything under the sun. Touch that wife who always arguing. Touch that child who's rebellious. And if those cases in this house, God, I ask you, God, to bring this house on, put on one accord. I pray that your love abound in every home. God, strengthen that man. Encourage him, God, that he is the head of the house. And he is a provider, even though he don't have a job. Encourage that woman, God, who's trying to make ends meet, and all the money that come in, God, is a few dollars. But you, God, will bring peace in that house. Thank you, Lord God, those who have came a long way on this Sunday morning. But you, God, you will give them in supernatural, download instructions to sustain this house. Sustain that woman, God, her mind, who's, she's about to lose her mind because things are not going her way. He's about to do something crazy because he's not making enough money. God, I ask you to bless that man. Bless that husband, Father God. Bless that single wife, God. Bless that single woman. Show yourself strong. I thank you right now, God. All you have done so far, you haven't stopped yet blessing. You have not stopped giving. You still raise us up every morning. You still open our eyes up every morning, God. You still allow us to walk on this green grass and on this earth with our own two legs. You still doing it, Jesus. As the songwriter used to say, Father God, you brought us a mighty long way. We thank you, Lord God, and we get a journey. We have all have a journey to finish, and we all have destiny to make. I give you praise, Father God. Every eye closed, every head bowed. If you're in this room right now, and God has ministered to your heart and to your mind, to your family, and you're looking for direction, and you said, Pastor, I enjoyed the service so far, but I'm lacking some things that you hadn't hit on, but I do feel that something you're on the edge. If that's you now, and you, as you saying, Father, help my family, I just don't know how to do it, come down to this altar. Come now. Bring your sister with you. Bring your girlfriend, whoever that may be in this house. Bring your wife with you. Come on down. Let us pray with you. You in this room right now, and you're looking for a church home. You've been running to every five different churches in the city. You just lost. And I'm telling you right now, now's the time to make a switch. Now's the time to make something solid and get with a family, a real family. If I'm talking to you, woman, man of God. Come on down here. You know who you are. Touch your neighbor and say, baby, that's you. Come on, brother, that's you. Come on down here. There's some people in this room right now that's been bad in the church for a while. And you want to rededicate yourself back to God. You used to be involved, but you just stopped going to church. Somebody, I don't know what happened. Come on back, woman of God. Come on back to she. Come on back to the family. Come on back. Anybody else? You know who you are. I'm not through yet. I know it's more. You know you ain't been in church in a while. You know who you are, man, woman of God. You know you just, Pastor, I'm just here because, you know, no, he's talking to you now. Anybody else? Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else need prayer? Pastor, I just want to agree with me about some things that I need to happen tomorrow. You need something to agree with you. The floor is open. Don't be scared. I'm telling you, something is in the atmosphere. It ain't because you feel the chills on your body. I'm telling you, it's thick. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Glory to God. Praise God, woman of God. Oh, the assignment on your life. Hallelujah. The assignment on your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, God, thank you. You know what you need. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Glory to God, I thank you. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. God, I pray now for this woman of God. What I'm hearing. The word avenue, that means something, that's a road you've got about to take on this road, taking this road. Caution. Oh my God, caution about this road. Taking your time about this road, this turn, this decision. You don't want to be foolish. You're making sure this time, whoever, before I decide, I don't want to make any mess up. So God, I thank you. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord God. This woman has been called by your name. And I grab her hand, but I feel her spirit, Lord God. There's a shift on her. There's a new day for her. There's a new view in life again. But I thank you now, God. You're so much stuck in this place. You know Jesus. You know God. But you hadn't heard which way to go. And I'm telling you right now, woman, God, hold my hand. Hold my hand. Father, thank you that you will give us supernatural instructions. Hallelujah, glory to God. Let it be a spontaneous moment in the spark in her mind. She may be in the car driving, she may be home washing the dishes, whatever it is, but God, just spark it in her mind. I see an angel sign to you. And everybody knows this. But this angel saying,